What's up, family? Andre here. Over the last several months, we have had a lot of discussion regarding the presidential election. Now that the election is over and we are moving toward a Biden-Harris administration, it is absolutely critical that we examine some of the proposals that potentially could be enacted as legislation. One of the key proposals of the Biden administration is the Biden tax plan. So today's video is all about examining all of the details of the Biden tax plan and how it impacts you and your money. But before we get started, please don't forget to smash that like button, hit the subscriber button, as well as the bell next to it to receive updated weekly content. Recently, President-elect Biden and his administration announced a major tax plan that significantly departs from the plan that was enacted in 2017 under President Trump. It is a major departure in several areas, including policies as well as provisions that were provided in that legislation. It also focuses on some of the areas that were of support under the current administration, which was lowering income tax rates as well as capital gains rates. The general overview of the Biden tax plan focuses on higher income rates for corporations and high-income individuals, while simultaneously targeting revised and new tax credit for low and middle income families. Social Security payroll tax will be extended to all income levels. The estate tax will be reduced by approximately 50%, and a step up in basis upon death would be repealed. What is a step up in basis? A step up in basis is a readjustment of an appreciated asset for tax purposes upon inheritance. The higher market value of the asset at the time of inheritance is considered for tax purposes. When the asset is passed on to a beneficiary, it is typically worth more than when the original owner acquired it. It receives a step up in basis so that the beneficiary's capital gains tax is minimized. Step up in basis is applied to the cost of the property transferred at death. The Biden tax plan will repeal many of the tax reductions which were implemented in late 2017. First, it would increase the top individual federal income tax rate from 37% to 39.6%. Second, it would increase the corporate income tax rate from 21% to 28%. For high-income individuals making $400,000 or more, itemized deductions would be capped at 28%. Other tax rates would be graduated so that individuals that are below the $400,000 income level would not see any rate increases. To make the tax exposure for wage earners and wealthy investors similar, individuals who are earning income above $1 million will have their investment income taxed at the same rate as ordinary income. Carried interest loophole would be eliminated, which is primarily focused at the private equity and hedge fund industry, where those individuals have been able to utilize their capital gains at a flat 20% versus ordinary income rates. Corporate income tax rates will go from 21% to 28%. And in an effort to have profitable companies not pay any tax, a 15% alternative minimum tax, or AMT, would be assessed on all book income of $100 million or more. All foreign income earned by U.S. companies' overseas operations would now be taxed at 21%, which is double the current rate. The Biden tax plan would also include provisions that would penalize companies for moving jobs overseas. It also would incentivize companies to invest in green energy, transportation, manufacturing, and infrastructure. Under this plan, businesses would be offered a variety of new tax credits, benefits to help during any series of layoffs, as well as small business owners being incentivized to provide retirement savings plans for their employees. Back to the AMT provision on booked income of $100 million or more by corporations, the key point of this provision would be the extent to which corporations report different income on their financial statements that exceeds the income on their corporate tax return. Biden tax plan emphasizes new and revised tax benefits for low to middle income families, or as titled in the plan, working families. It emphasizes the use of tax credits, often refundable tax credits, which are more favorable than tax deductions, which typically benefit high-income taxpayers. What is a tax credit? A tax credit is the amount of money that can be subtracted from the tax bill that you owe dollar for dollar. It is typically more favorable than tax reductions because the tax credit allows you to be able to reduce the total amount that you owe and not just your taxable income. In regard to retirement plans, under the Biden plan, there are provisions and proposals that would seek to be able to level the tax benefits for the contributions to 401k plans and other retirement plans across all income levels. Depending on the details and new provisions for this particular item under the Biden tax plan, the high income earner could be substantially affected by this change in law. For example, a high income earner with a marginal tax rate of 35% making contributions to their retirement plans would go to a 20% tax credit under this current provision. That would change their annual savings from $6,800 per year to $3,900 per year. Child and dependent care. The Biden tax plan seeks to increase the child and dependent care tax credit from the current rate of $3,000 per year to $8,000 per year, with a maximum contribution level of $16,000 for multiple dependents. The child tax credit would be fully refundable and rise from its current level of $2,000 per year to $3,000 per year for children from ages 6 to 17, with a credit also available for $3,600 per year for children under the age of 6. Biden plan looks to increase access to health care and assistance with the high cost of insurance premiums. They will offer refundable tax credits to limit the spending on insurance premiums to no more than 8.5% of annual income. In addition, the plan would offer increased tax benefits for those individuals who purchase long-term care insurance. First-time home buyer credit. Under the Biden plan, they will seek to restore the first-time home buyer credit, which was implemented during the Great Recession. This tax credit will allow up to a maximum of $15,000 for a first-time home buyer that will be available at the time of purchase. It is also refundable and can be given in advance and allows for them to have it at the time of purchase, which in the past, it has only been available for them to use this credit when they file their taxes. Student loan debt, a big topic that has been a much discussion during the presidential election. Under the Biden tax plan, there would be some provisions to help with the enormous and overwhelming student loan debt crisis. Under their plan, there would be extensions in terms of payment deferral, as well as loan forgiveness. One of the provisions in their plan would be that after 20 years, student loan debt is completely forgiven. Two key features of the Biden tax plan would focus on high income earners. One of those features is the Social Security payroll tax, and the other is a reduction in the state tax by 50%. Payroll taxes. Currently for 2020, the Social Security payroll tax is 6.2% for the employer and employee portion, up to $137,700. For self-employed individuals, their Social Security payroll tax is 12.4% of net profits. The Biden plan would seek to add an additional 6.2% of Social Security payroll tax to all income over $400,000 or more. Under this provision, income between $137,700 and $400,000 would have no additional Social Security payroll tax assessed. Estate tax exemption. Under the Biden plan, they would seek to reduce the estate tax exemption by 50% from its current level of $11.5 million. Okay, let's recap. Top individual federal income tax rate will change from 37% to 39.6%. The corporate income tax rate would change from 21% to 28%. An additional 15% alternative minimum or AMT tax would also be assessed on all booked income over $100 million or more. Individuals earning $400,000 or more would pay an additional 6.2% Social Security payroll tax. Maximum child and dependent tax credit would rise from $3,000 to $8,000 per year and be capped at $16,000 per year for multiple dependents. Relief for student loan debt would include loan forgiveness as well as deferral payments. A key provision would include forgiveness of all student loan debt after 20 years. First-time home buyer credit will be restored to a maximum of $15,000 for first-time home buyers that will be refundable and in advance at the time of purchase. The estate tax exemption will be reduced by 50%. What's the bottom line with the Biden tax plan? There are several changes and provisions that are being proposed within the Biden tax plan that can affect you and your family financially. It's important to understand where you currently are with the current tax law, and then understand with these new changes how that is going to affect your tax burden going forward. But keep in mind that these are just proposed changes by the executive branch. They have to work in conjunction and coordination with the legislative branch, both the House and the Senate. Depending on the makeup of both houses of Congress, this can be a very challenging provision to get implemented into legislation. It's also equally important to make the distinction between what is said during a campaign and what is being implemented during governing. A lot of rhetoric and a lot of proposals are communicated during a campaign. But once the governance starts, the reality of the hard data and the numbers meets up with those proposals, and typically major changes are made to that legislation. The combination of potential conflicts with the legislative branch and the actual data and numbers as a result of revenue shortfalls due to this pandemic will almost guarantee that there will be changes to the current Biden tax plan. It will be important for you to monitor updates and see how this impacts you and your money going forward. And there you have a summary of the Biden tax plan. Hopefully now you have a better understanding of the details in the proposal, as well as how it impacts you and your families. Please don't forget to smash that like button, hit the subscriber button, as well as the bell next to it, in order to receive updated weekly content. Thank you for tuning in.